Starting off today's mailbag with Vancouver Island Brewing's title series, Nanaimo Bar Imperial Porter. I remember having one of these back before Christmas and thinking it was quite nice, so I decided to have another. So here we go. First item in says cable socket. Ooh, did I bump through it? Oh no, I just hit the bag. Okay. It is just a cable. Two male connectors. This is, okay, 3.5 millimeter down to a 2 millimeter. Okay, so this is for the little action camera. This guy here, the microphone input on it is the smaller 2 millimeter one. So there we go. And now I can take an output from something else. And hopefully that will sound better than the microphone that came with it if I connect it to something else.
Stereo, 2.5 millimeter to 3.5 millimeter plug, male headphones, headset, car, aux jack, MP3 jack, cable, da-da-da-da-da. Currently selling for $1.92. It was $1.82 Canadian when I bought it, and free shipping. Woohoo! Nothing really surprising to say down here. An 1/8 inch or 3.5 millimeter jack on one end, plug, and a 2.5 millimeter or 3/32 inch on the other end. It is about 0.5 meter long. What else you want to say about it?
Next in, we have two integrated circuits, according to the lies on the package. Oh, it's two kits. Hey, this one looks like it's got a speaker in it and a couple of 14-pin ICs. So the two chips, there's a CD4011 and an NE556, which is 2 5-5-5s in a single package. So we have a couple of oscillators over there, and I can't remember what a 4011 does. Okay, so the 4011 looks like it's gates, and we got a couple of a transistor there, a couple of jacks, the two sections of the 5-5-6. That will be inverting. So I'm not entirely familiar with this circuit, but it should be a fun one to play with and put together. And I'm assuming, yeah, there's the speaker jack there. So I'm assuming it's making noise.
Dual way burglar alarm kit, 120 ambulance alarm sound, student principal experiment training, CD40011, circuit board, NE556 chip. Cost me $1.82 with $1.53 shipping from AliExpress. So I guess that explains it. It's an ambulance alarm sound alarm, dual burglar alarm kit alarm. Looks like this dude's got lots of kits. I may have to come back here for some more simple kits. I do like a simple kit.
And the other kit has a battery holder in it. And what does the schematic say about this? We have three buttons. We have a 24HC08. There's three sections of it. We have a 4075, little transistor driving, a B buzzer, I guess. Is there a buzzer in there? Yes, there is a little buzzer in there. Okay. Three push buttons. Is this one of those like game show timer kind of things, maybe, or game show like who pushes the button first kind of thing?
So this one was also dirt cheap, $1.31 for the kit and $1.32 for shipping. Oh, okay, it's not the game show type circuit. Basically, when two of the three, or when a majority of people vote, i.e., push their buttons, then that causes the LED to light up. Okay. For some reason, I thought it was the game show thing, but whatever. There is what it is. Again, a fairly straightforward little kit, but should be fun to put together. And when I do, I'll go through the schematic and how it actually works a little bit more thoroughly so that we can actually examine it. And that will give us a chance to play with these chips.
Next thing in says SOT 223 to DIP S... adapter. Okay. That could easily be what it is. Bags and bags. What's in... Oh, there's something else in that bag. Oh, there's a whole bunch of things. Okay. So first of all, yeah, that is surface mount transistor to Breakout pins adapter in two different form factors, two different sizes. Okay, so that's nice. This little bag looks like it's got some heat sinks in it. This little bag, I have no idea because it's all wrapped up in something opaque. Oh, come on, get out of there. Looks like circuit board material.
Why? Why have you done this to me?
Oh, okay. This looks like... this is 8-pin surface mount IC to 8-pin dip. And again, two different sizes. What is that? SDB 10 and SOT 23. Okay. Always handy when you're breadboarding and experimenting.
10 pieces double-sided SMD SOT 223 to dip and SIP 3 adapter PCB board DIY. The 10 of them for $1.76 Canadian with free shipping. And from the same seller, 10 pieces aluminum heat sink for step stick. Whatever, 8.8 by 8.8, I'm assuming millimeters, $1.66 for the 10 of those. And the ones that were so hard to get out of their package, 10 pieces, SOT 23, SOP 10, MSOP 10, UMAX, SOP 23, blah, 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 to DIP 10. No, not DIP 10. Are those 10 pins? Those are 10 pins, huh? Oops, I was expecting 8. Why did I order 10 pins? Damn it. Anyway, $1.69 and free shipping.
Oh, right. And there was this other package in there, too. What have they given me there? Given, sold. Oh, hey. That looks like another 2.5 to 3.5 millimeter adapter. And that one could be much more useful because I've got several microphones that use a 3.5 millimeter on them. Okay. And again, that would plug into that little camera, that one over there.
And finally, from the same seller, 2.5 millimeter male plug to 3.5 millimeter female jack stereo aux audio TPN adapter, blah, blah, blah. $1.86. This guy had a lot of stuff for under $2 and all free shipping, which is just excellent. None of it is entirely earth shattering, but it's all really handy stuff to have. So, you know, obviously, that's why I grabbed it.
Next in via Emirates Post, it says transfer line. No idea what that is. It's a cable. It's a USB-C male to female extension cable. Okay, that could come in handy. As I mentioned before, I am slowly upgrading my cable stash and my adapters and whatnot to USB-C as I'm getting more and more things that speak USB-C. And of course, one of the benefits of USB-C is it'll plug in both ways. Nice. And this one looks like it is about a meter and a half long. So that'll come in super handy. Nice and thick too. Hopefully that means it's heavy duty and isn't just a whole bunch of rubber.
New Type-C USB 3.1 male to USB-C female extension data cable extender cord. From pup.fashion20. It seems a little bit expensive at $6.39, but that was the least expensive one that I could find at the time. And of course, it had free shipping. Doesn't say anything about the gauge of wire in it or anything else, but... Yeah, the only thing it's got for a spec is that it's a meter and a half long and it's USB-C on both ends.
And the last thing in calls itself adapter. As usual, it is the largest package, so we save it for last, just in case it's the most exciting. I hope it is. But you never know with these things. I have been let down before. Solidly packaged. Lots of stuff around it. And in a box. Come on, what do you got? Oh, hello. It's a power supply with a dent in the side of it. So, AC input either 110 or 220 volts, plus or minus 15%, so that should cover all the world standards. DC output 12 volts, 15 amps. On this end, we have a ground, live, and neutral. And on this end, we just have a V plus and a V minus. Not seeing any adjustment screws that are accessible through this. Not seeing anything switchable. So it just does one thing. It creates 12 volts and it can supply up to 15 amps.
12 volt power supply, switch, LED transformer, LED driver adapter, lighting transformers. From Find Your LED, I paid $17.98 Canadian or $13.99 American with free shipping. So that hasn't changed. They have a whole variety of them at different power levels, but this is the one that I chose. Well, that is horribly difficult to read, but basically it says it's got shortage protection, overload protection, over voltage protection, widely used in industrial automation, right? Compliant with CCC, FCC, CE, Roche, okay. Working temperature is 0 to 40 degrees Celsius. Ambient humidity, anything less of actually liquid water, good. Indoor use only, okay.
So first things first, it has a ground or earth pin there, so just make sure.
Yep, that's good.
Always like to check those things. Now I guess the responsible thing to do would be to power it up and see what it does. So for this experiment, just initially, I'm going to be a little bit naughty and not use a grounded cable. Just because I don't have one handy with the ends all stripped already, but I do have this two-wire cable handy and stripped. So we'll just use that and pretend that it's grounded. Safety cover on. Plug it in and see what happens. No explosions. Doesn't zap me. That's a good start. So let's see what's in here. Negative is that side, right. 12.08. That looks like a win. Now then, why did I get a 15 amp 12 volt power supply? Well, do you remember these lights up here that I did in a project a couple of years ago?
That panel up there? It's actually being run off two different power supplies right now. Just a couple of laptop-style power bricks. And some time ago, one of them died on me. Just stopped. Which is fine. They were cheap. Free, actually. Probably just offcasts. So, a few of you may remember when that happened. I didn't say anything, but you pointed out that you were hearing a high-pitched whine in the background of my videos for a few weeks. And that was because I was using something else as a temporary power supply. I couldn't hear it because tinnitus and old, but it turned out to be the problem. So, I ordered this. And I'm hoping that this, being able to supply 15 amps, will be more than enough to supply all those lights up above me here. I'm not sure if I will do that on video or if I'll just do it behind the scenes and you'll notice. Actually, no, you probably won't notice anything different. For me, it'll free up one extra plug and make my lights a little bit more stable, maybe. So there is the contents of today's Mailbag Monday haul. Quite a variety and a few things that are going to have some utility. A few that are going to show up in future projects and a bit of shop stock. All in all, nice and well-rounded. Do I care too much about shipping times? No, they're all, what the hell. This was 19 days. These two kits were 49 days from AliExpress. The USB-C cable was 79 days. That's by far the longest. And all the rest of it only took 30 days. So global shipping is still weird and random. I guess that's not a surprise. Thanks for stopping by. As always, thanks to my Patreon supporters and my YouTube channel members and anybody who clicks on that thank button down there for helping to support this. Keep the mailbags rolling in and, of course, keep my beer fridge full. Very important. Questions and comments down below as usual. I'll talk to you later.